Our top story this afternoon is about the escalating tensions between the US and China. The Trump administration has now imposed sanctions on Hong Kong's chief, Carrie Lam. This over her role in curtailing the political freedoms of the people of Hong Kong. The latest news coming in is that China has denounced Washington's decision to sanction key officials in Hong Kong and in the mainland. In a statement released by China's office in Hong Kong, it says that the ill intentions of US politicians to support people who are anti-China and messing up Hong Kong have been clearly revealed. Hong Kong has slammed the newly imposed sanctions by the United States. Hong Kong's Secretary for Commerce said in a statement, and I quote, "This kind of sanction targeting officials or leaders of another country is savage, disproportionate and unreasonable." This Hong Kong official has also warned that there could be a possible retaliation against the US businesses in the international financial hub. The United States has expressed its discontent over China's recent clampdown on the historically independent financial center, that is Hong Kong. Sanctions have been imposed on 11 senior Chinese Communist Party officials and their Hong Kong allies. These individuals will have all their property and assets in the US frozen. These are the first set of sanctions against officials from China and Hong Kong over the suppression of the pro-democracy movement as well as dissent within the territory. They are being imposed as actions following an executive order signed by the US President Donald Trump in July, seeking to punish China. Sanctioning the Chinese officials marks yet another blow by the Trump administration against Beijing. Last month, the Trump administration imposed sanctions on the Chinese government, including a senior member of the Communist Party, over human rights abuses against the largely Muslim Uyghur minority. So what exactly are these US sanctions against Hong Kong's officials? Sanctioned officials' properties in the US will be seized and their financial assets in the country will be frozen immediately. Transactions between the US residents and these sanctioned officials are now banned. This means that US residents cannot send money or goods to the sanctioned Hong Kong officials and vice versa. Washington has put curbs on some of the top Hong Kong officials. This includes Chief Executive Carrie Lam, who has been accused of implementing Beijing's policies of suppression on Hong Kong. She has also been accused of trying to extradite activists to China. Hong Kong Secretary for Justice Theresa Cheng has been accused of playing a major role in the national security law's implementation. The city's Secretary for Security John Lee has been accused of assisting Carrie Lam in policymaking and introducing a new police unit to enforce the security law. Hong Kong's police commissioner, Chris Tang, has been sanctioned for supporting the security law and cracking down on the protesters. Tang's predecessor, Stephen Lo, has also been accused of suppressing demonstrations. More than 4,000 protesters were arrested under his leadership. Pro-democracy activist Nathan Law has hailed these US sanctions against Hong Kong's officials, saying that the move shows that those responsible for human rights violations must be punished. Listen in.
The US government has made a very clear point that these people who are responsible for the human rights violation in Hong Kong should be punished, and I welcome this decision because it is important for the international community to implement counteractions to these human rights violators while there is no checks and balances in the system. There will be more and more individuals being sanctioned. There will be second wave, third wave, and the tension between China and the US will rise. So this is just, I think, is a starter of the whole disciplinary action.